So in this tutorial, I'm going to show how an Arduino can be used to receive data over DMX, and then it can process it and use it to make useful stuff. So this is a basic six-channel controller. This is our DMX signal coming in. This is a transceiver chip, which is taking our data from our differential DMX bus and then transferring it into a 5-volt logic line, which is then fed into the receiver serial port of the Arduino and then processed in code. So I'm going to go through all of these bits, and then you'll be able to use it for DMX. So I've just uploaded a very simple sketch at the moment, which is a switcher sketch, and it just toggles the LED on the pin 13 between on and off, depending on what the value given for that channel or that data. So if it's above 127, it's on. If it's below, it's off. So a bit more about DMX. This is a controller. It sends DMX packets. A DMX packet has up to 512 channels of data. Each channel is just is 8 bits wide or a byte wide. So it can hold a value from 0 to 255. The DMX bus itself is a differential bus, and the data is sent in things called frames, which is similar to packets. I'll put up some links on how DMX packets frames actually work and the physical side of the DMX protocol and how the bus actually works in terms of differential. So I'll put links up to those, and it's probably best just to go off and have a quick look at those. So this is the receiver circuit for DMX, and it's all based around this chip here, which is a Texas Instruments SN75176, and that is a differential bus driver. It's quite a clever chip. It can be configured in two ways, either as a receiver or as a transmitter, and you can, in theory, program it to switch between the two and use a differential bus for bidirectional data. So DMX is actually unidirectional. It's only, you have a master and then you have multiple slaves. You have a controller and then lots of lights, and you can have up to 32 devices per bus, and then you have to have repeaters and stuff. So let's look at how this is configured. So I'll link in the data sheet for this chip, and you can see pretty much how it's wired. There's only 8 pins. So pin 1, which is over here, is actually the 5-volt signal, or the logic signal output, which goes off to our Arduino. Then the next 3 pins I've tied to the ground, and that's because this is in receive mode at the moment. You can change the configuration of 2 of those pins, which, so one of them's receive enable, one of them's like the transmit enable, and there's the transmit signal as well. So I'm not using the transmit, so I pull them both to ground, and then the receive enable needs to be pulled to ground to enable reception. And then over the other side of the chip, so pin 5 is ground, pin 8 is 5 volt in, or VCC, and then you connect your differential bus into, well, the ground goes to the ground, so that's just a ground reference. So my ground on this is just a 3-pin XLR. DMX can use 5, well, it should use 5, but a lot of people use 3, and I'm going to use 3. And then this works for me. You might have to swap these other two round. So these two are your signal plus and minus, which is pins 2 and 3. So pin 3 is signal plus, and that goes into pin 6 of this chip. And then signal minus, which is pin 2 of the XLR, goes into pin 7 of this chip. So you've got, from pins 1 to 8, you've got your signal out, you've got ground, 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 then you've got pin 5 is ground, pin 6 is pin 3 on the XLR, pin 7 is pin 2 on the XLR, and then pin 8 is your 5 volt in. On the Arduino, we're going to be using pin 0, which is our serial receiving pin, or RX, and we're going to be using some of the hardware features of the Arduino chip, or the actual processor chip. So this library that we'll be using is out in the public domain. It requires a bit of tweaking to make it work, and it uses hardware registers of the chip. So once the sketch is uploaded, you can't use the serial libraries within the Arduino. You just can't use them in the same way because we're utilizing some of those registers for DMX reception, and we will be making some modifications to the core library files of the Arduino platform as well. So yeah, the receiving goes into pin 0. When you're uploading the sketch, you have to have that unplugged, and then you plug it in afterwards and it will receive DMX. And then if you want to change your sketch, you have to unplug it, upload your sketch, and then plug it back in again. Otherwise you'll get a upload error, basically saying it can't communicate with the Arduino. And that's the reason why you can't upload with something plugged into pin 0. So the next thing we're going to need is the code. You can get this from the Arduino website. If you search for Arduino and then ARDMX, this contains snippets of code, and you'll have to put them all together to make it work and change a few things, which I will go through in this video. Or I will put up my sketch, and you can just use that. And this works for the Uno. The original, I think, was written for Mega, but they're just different registers, and you'll see that in a minute. Anyway, so there is, have a read of this information here. It's pretty useful, but if you grab the code, so there's some variables and definitions, there's a bit for the setup function, there's a whole section on an interrupt subroutine, and then there's a loop function that's here. I've written my own, which you'll find in the file. So if you just copy all of these across for the moment, which I've done already, and then I shall show you what needs to be changed and what you can leave alone. So the first thing is this RX status pin. That is just a LED that flashes with reception. So if you wish to use that, you can. If you don't, you can get rid of it, and then you can remove all the references to it. Next thing is this volatile. Well, I don't know what it is, but basically it forms an array which stores the values. So DMX RX field, and then square brackets, and then it contains a number. That number is the amount of channels that you want to use. So if you've got a fixture that's just in, say, an RGB fixture, you only need 3 DMX channels. So you can change that to 3. I'm just going to be using 1 for this sketch because it's a simple turning an LED off or on depending on whether the value is above or below 127. So you can change that number to however many channels you wish to receive. And later on in the code, basically, it grabs the DMX, but it doesn't grab all of it. It only grabs the channels that it wants. So it's a bit more efficient on the memory. Anyway, there is a DMX address, well, variable. If you leave that as, there's an enum, leave that as it is, and the GMX state, or the DMX state, leave that as it is. Okay, so in the setup, this uses the hardware serial library with a slight change. But if we'll go through that in a minute, and it sets the pin mode there of the RX status pins as an output, sets the initial state to idle, and originally this would be set to 3. It's just a DMX address that it starts from. So you could derive the start address from some inputs. So you could have a set of DIP switches, and you could calculate your DMX start address. That's where you'd put it. This is where you would store that address. But for now, I'm just going to use channel 1. This address is not 0 indexed, it's 1 indexed. So 1 is the first DMX channel, and I'm going to listen to that. I've also added pin mode 13 output in because I'm going to be using pin 13, or the onboard LED, just as the output. So if channel 1's above 127, it's going to be on. If it's below, it's going to be off. Okay. Now we come to the interesting bit. This is a completely rewritten interrupt subroutine, which is specific for DMX. And when it was written, I think it was written, or this particular code that's on the website was written for a Mega. So I'm using an Uno, so I need to change some registers. Now I happen to know, because I've read the data sheets, that where it says the USART state equals UCSR1A. Now that's the address for the first serial
on Omega, which is actually the second one because it's zero indexed. And on the Uno, there is only one, and it is only zero indexed. So that has to be changed to zero. So the UCSR1A needs to be UCSR0A. And then the DMX bike below that, that register also needs to be changed from UDR1 to UDR0. And that's just changing the registers. Basically to use different registers within different platforms. And the next thing we need to change is, down here it says, if USART state and bracket or open bracket 1 greater than, no, 1 less than FE1. Again, that needs to be FE0, not 1, because we're only using the first one. And I think that is it for register changes. And the rest of the code, I think you can leave as it is. There is a couple of errors in this code, which will flag up when we come to compile. And then the last thing is, down here, I've written a different loop to the one that's on the website. This is just basically looks at that value from that field. The received fields are put into this array that we've defined at the top, which is the DMX RX field. And the array is zero indexed. So zero in the array is the first channel after the channel reached that you've set the DMX to. It may sound a bit complicated, but basically you tell it what channel to start at, and then it puts that channel into 0, the next channel into 1, the next channel into 2, etc., etc., up to the number of channels that you put in the array at the very top. So, I'll put this whole thing up as 1, so you can just download this. If you quickly verify it, you will see that there is some glitches where basically the definition of the RX status pin is one thing in one place and something else in another. So if you just make sure they're all the same, you can avoid that. So I'll just change those. The one I'll upload will have the correct ones in, so it will just be a case of you can use it and it will work fine. Okay, so that's that part of it. Now we need to go into one of the Arduino platform's core files and make some modifications to it. Okay, so on the website, in section 2, which is just off the side of the screen, it mentions about changing the hardware serial file. Now, the hardware serial file is located in your program files, Arduino, wherever you've set that, the install for your Arduino. Then it's within the hardware, the Arduino, and then cores, and then Arduino, and it should be in there, hardware serial.cpp. So the first thing to do is create a copy of that file, because you don't wish to lose the original. So you can name that whatever you want, but I'm going to call it hardware serial.cpp.old. And then I've already got one in there called hardware serial.cpp.dmx, which is one that I've already modified. But if you go into the original one, and you'll see lots and lots of code. And basically, there is a section of code which needs to be commented out. And it starts basically where the first reference to the USART or USART 0 underscore RX underscore VECT. It starts there and it goes down to the next definition, which is the USART1 RX vector definition. And basically you need to comment that whole section out, which is what I've done here. I'll upload this file, so if you want to, you can just drop this file in replace of your hardware serial.cpp file, and it should work. So going back to our Arduino sketch, now we've changed the hardware serial.cpp file, we can just upload our sketch to the Arduino. It'll recompile and upload. It's taking its time. What's gone wrong? Ah, I've still got my receiver pin still plugged in, so I just need to unplug that and then I'll re-upload it. So it's just unplugged now. Upload. Brilliant. So that's uploaded, so I can plug my receive pin back in and then just confirm that works, which it does. So that's pretty much it. That's how you receive DMX to Arduino or DMX on Arduino. So the key things to remember is that the receiving circuit has to be wired into receive mode, and that when you upload your sketch, you need to have your receive pin not connected to anything else. Other than that, it's just a case of knowing that the interrupt subroutine that's written specifically for DMX won't work with the standard hardware serial.cpp file. It needs to be modified. And then if you go on and do other sketches, which then require serial, you have to change it back, which is why you need to create a copy of it first. So I'll upload all of these files, and then you can just download them, play with them, and let me know how you get on.